Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to this fantastic pose off. Before we proceed any further, I want to backtrack for a second. I want to address something. You mentioned two episodes ago.
Yeah.
It was two episodes ago. You said that at one point, Colonel Sanders got sued by KFC.
Yes.
For shit talking the restaurant and all that.
Yep.
Okay. You showed me a video by Fact Fiend telling me about this.
With Carl Smallwood.
I found, on my own time, I found an article on a website called Grunge. I don't know how trustworthy this is. This is what I found, but it seems to go with what you had found. Yep. So, here we go. I'm going to try to skim through to the good parts. Okay. Although the Colonel remained the symbol of a company, blah, 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 yada, yada, Sanders came to hate the changes the company made after he was no longer in charge. The New Yorker reported Sanders dreamed of gravy so good it'll make you throw away the darn chicken and just eat the gravy, quote unquote. However, the gravy made by post-Sanders franchisees was decidedly not the Colonel's gravy. A company executive was quoted as saying, "Let's face it, the Colonel's gravy was fantastic, but you had to be a Rhodes Scholar to cook it," which was probably code for too expensive.
Yeah.
And it basically goes into how he would visit franchises, he would try the gravy, like the quote-unquote company gravy, and how he would often just like grab it and just throw it to the floor and insult it and call it slop and sludge. And one quote was pure wallpaper paste made with tap water, flour, and starch, to which they added, quote, some sludge, unquote. His criticism of KFC was so harsh that the company he founded sued him for libel in 1978. The case was thrown out, but don't worry, it happened again. This is later. Let me see when this happened. I was trying to find like a... couldn't find a second one. Or the other instance.
And we'll link both this story and the video that gave me the info below.
Yeah. But yeah, here we go. It says that eventually he... let's see, where's it at? He and his once mistress, now wife Claudia, opened a new competing restaurant that served food that rose to the Colonel's standards. As reported in People Magazine, the restaurant known as Claudia Sanders, the Colonel's Lady Dinner House, would sell sit-down style dinners of ham and lobster in addition to chicken. They attempted, blah, blah, blah. KFC didn't like it. They sued him to the tune of $120 million. The case was settled for $1 million, and Sanders sold the restaurant. That the Claudia Sanders Dinner House still exists, though. You can visit it off Iowa 64, east of Louisville. It is the only non-KFC restaurant that sells a fully authorized version of the original Colonel Sanders fried chicken recipe. So apparently, if you are in the Louisville area, you can get actual...
Kentucky fried chicken.
Actual Colonel-approved Kentucky fried chicken, and it is not from a named Kentucky Fried Chicken restaurant.
Nice.
Holy shit. So apparently that was a thing.
Yeah, it really happened.
Okay, all right. Because it sounded fishy. It sounds like something...
one of those weird things you read on the internet that gets repeated enough that you just think it's real.
Yeah, like a game of telephone where it just gets more and more distorted as it goes. But okay, yeah, sure, why not? All right, are we ready to move on? Now that we've gone over that bit of lore.
All right, let's see if I'm dead now.
Oh, your boy who ate the tentacle? The braised battle axe tentacle? I think I left something in the oven.
I don't feel so good.
Oh!
It killed him!
Is
He's now wearing a sheet.
Where did you acquire that sheet from, sir?
No, he died. That's his ghost form.
How were you able to procure that sheet so quickly and prepare it with a deadpan face?
I love his little blinking eyes.
Are they blinking? Oh, they are blinking. I couldn't even tell.
It killed him.
Everyone step back. Don't take another bite. When you look back at the plate, the rest of it is gone. You notice the tip of the tentacle being slurped up in Pop's mouth.
Pop, no! I mean, Pop kinda.
Pop kinda?
Do you like Pop?
Pop, no.
No. This is a terrible tragedy.
What a disaster. Oh, dear. Pop winces in pain for just a moment, then it is almost immediately back to his oblivious self. Oh.
Oopsie.
God damn it.
Tastes like poison.
Oh, does it? The entire class has gathered to watch Pop's final moments. Shock has frozen the whole crowd. They are as motionless as statues.
The dog.
Oh, he does not look... Oh, the class bell rings, disrupting the moment and snapping everyone back to reality. It would appear that Pop's enthusiasm for trying new things, despite obvious danger, has inoculated him against poisons of all kinds. Is poison a mind over matter thing?
No, but it can be a grow immunity to it through incredibly small doses over time. You know, like Iocane powder. No?
That was the Princess Bride stuff, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay, I was like, Iocane sounds familiar. Why do I remember... Okay.
Clearly, there was not enough in this tentacle next to you.
Okay. I'm not sure the professors here make enough money.
Hello? I just turned into a ghost over here.
Ghosts, don't interrupt. Seeing that you're shaken up by that really annoying student and all his nonsense, Colonel Sanders approaches you. I'm sorry that you had to go through that. Please, let me walk you home.
Jackpot! Oh, it's the student.
This is you, the student. You're the ghost.
What? Like, for real? Oh, come on.
So, are you applying more enthusiasm to him when dead than he had when he was alive?
Yes.
You follow Colonel Sanders out of the room. Are we... Thank you.
I clicked it and it didn't work.
At night, the school building has taken on another vibe entirely. It's dark and more than a little spooky.
I mean, there are ghosts about.
Colonel Sanders stands in the quad's neon glow and speaks softly. Those mashed potatoes you made in class today...
Before going on, I want you to know, they're not a great representation of my skills. I didn't even realize I was making them.
They were amazing. Tasting them, it reminded me why I became so passionate about food to begin with.
You've made the Colonel cry.
I know, he looks a little bit upset.
Like painfully reminiscent.
Colonel Sanders is getting choked up. Cooking is obviously important to him, in a way that you find inspiring.
I mean, nostalgia does mean the little pain, so...
What?
Yeah, the word nostalgia, it means, like, the little pain. Yeah.
I'll take your word for it. I'm not... I don't think we teach linguistics on this channel. Now might be a perfect time to tell him you're developing feelings for him. Are we?
Colonel Sanders?
Yes, Wendy McDolan?
There's something I need to tell you.
Hold it right there.
Hi, Van the Man.
Goddamn.
There's something I need to tell you first.
Is he in love with him?
Oh, jeez.
You see, when I was just a boy, I had a dream that one day I would be the greatest chef the world has ever seen. And every day since, I have been working toward that dream, day and night, never stopping, never resting. Also, lifting a lot of weights. Like so many weights!
We should follow our dreams with all of our hearts, that our souls may grant them like wishes floating on a shooting star.
Hey, no, you... Shut up! I'm the one here to say inspirational stuff and be the star of the story!
Okay, Goku.
Also, I noticed his star pompadour just shot straight up. Oh, and then it went limp again.
Are we forgetting that your cooking literally killed a guy?
You can't prove that.
I also saw you kill that guy. What was his name? I believe his legal name was Student. Somewhere in the distance, you hear a long, sad sigh.
Forget him. We're talking about me. Me, 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 me. I'm the hero.
Oh.
All right. What?
we seem to have taken a turn somewhere. Do you remember anything that brought this on?
No.
Like this?
Did the ghost turn into this? Who wants to be the spork monster?
I'm gonna say this. If I voice him, I have run out of deep and regal voices. I will be using a comically high-pitched voice, so if you want to volunteer...
Oh, yeah, no, I definitely want to volunteer.
Then go for it.
The Spork Monster is here to fight a hero!
Oh, dear. Dots!
Shut you up, Van Van the Man Man.
I think I left the fridge door open. Later, nerds!
How dare you threaten me just as I was letting down my guard and connecting with another chef on an emotional level?
Yeah.
Be afraid. Be very afraid of me because I'm a monster. See?
He's rhyming on purpose. Is he rhyming on purpose or is that just a coincidence?
Is he's rhyming on purpose?
You're right. It's weird. That's why I read it. He's rhyming on purpose or is it just a coincidence?
When you said it, I was thinking, how did he mess that up? And I looked at the line. I was like, oh, that's how you messed it up. What is this?
Yeah. My brain tried to autocorrect.
Yeah. But before you can discuss syntax any further.
Hey, wait a minute.
It's a turn-based fight sequence.
Sweet! What will you do?
What will you do? I'm confused.
I am happy.
I'm glad you are.
Let's defend first, just to see what he's doing.
I'm confused than anything. You decide to defend. Which defense will you choose?
Trepidation.
We have
clearly
a choice. You close your eyes tight, but then open one just enough to squint and see the spork monster across the battlefield. For some reason, this makes you feel more prepared for what comes next. Spork monster goes on the attack. They spit hot gravy at you. You take one damage. So where's our HP then? If this,
I don't know.
That lot of good that defense did.
Ow. Alright, attack.
You decide to go on the attack.
Cook with love or chow down? Cook with love.
Cook with love deals one damage. Spork monster won't forget this. Was he just bailing? Spork monster focuses their mashed mind and draws in energy from Mother Earth itself. They grow larger and more intimidating. How will you respond? I'm pretty attack. Sure, yeah, attack or defend didn't do squat before. Which attack will you use?
Cook with love again, apparently.
Cook with love does one damage. Spork monster is no quitter. Buffed up and ready to rumble, they go on the attack once again. Spork monster uses tensile. You take two damage from the attack.
Ow.
If you take much more damage, you're not going to survive the battle. Before we continue, I just want to say,
yeah,
I appreciate their effort.
Yeah,
but this feels very half-assed.
Oh yeah, this is clearly an arbitrary thing.
You decide to go on the attack. Cook with love does one damage. Spork monster is using cheese sauce onto the lawn of the quad. I wonder who is going to have to clean that up. Feeling vulnerable, Spork monster prepares for its ultimate attack, rounded edge. Vile villain, your reign of terror stops here. He has a very unconvincing look on his face.
Yeah, he's a little nervous.
Like he's not sure of his ability to do anything, except Colonel Sanders summons the energy of 1,000 chickens?
Summon that song, Chicken Attack?
Oh no. Oh.
Get Ryan, a little chest there.
I'm pretty sure I asked this question before, but I feel like it's a question worth repeating. Am I still wearing pants right now?
I'm not gonna look.
Pot Pie Power Pinch. Pot Pie Power Pinch does 10 damage.
Damn.
Spork Monster is defeated.
You.
That's a defeat face?
Saved me.
An injured Spork Monster spews steam into the night.
Spare this wretched beast.
Oh, you know what? That's your call. I would have just fucking ended him. I would have ended him. You managed to tamp down your disgust at the sight of this gnarly beast long enough to realize that he is still a living creature with a pure soul who deserves your pity, not your wrath. If he's a pure soul, why did he just instigate an attack like that?
I don't know. Be gone, beast, and don't you dare come back for a follow-up encounter tomorrow.
I am quite certain he's going to come back for a follow-up encounter tomorrow.
I won't forget this, and I certainly won't be back, like you said.
The spork monster scuttles off into the night. The defeated monster left behind a special item? It appears at first to be a cookbook, but upon closer inspection, it's so much more. It's a book of magic spells with a golden chicken on the cover.
Want it.
Can we say that that's a cookbook?
Sure.
You open the cover and find a library card tucked inside.
Do you like that he's still just standing there in his pose?
Yeah. God damn it. The last name to have signed it out is Borko. I think that's Sprinkle's name. Borko. That name sounds strangely familiar.
Borko Sprinkles?
Is it? Your blood is pumping as you stand in the quiet of the night, holding the mysterious book in your hands. As you come down from your battle buzz, you realize that your final attack has left you completely depleted. The world around you begins to fade away. Without any energy to keep your eyes open, darkness overtakes you.
Got him back to our room. Yeah!
Brian?
What?
Why is he in our room? Why did he bring us
to... Well, you see, when two grown-ups love each other very much...
Have we established our character is indeed grown up?
Yes.
Are you sure?
We're in college.
Are you
sure?
Which
is a trade college, so I imagine that's after regular college, so yeah.
Does Pop look like he's old enough to be in college?
Yes. It's all the poison he's eaten. It's stunted his growth.
Okay, you know what?
What's that? Damn your devilishly clever ability to maintain consistency. I know.
I mean, in some spans of thinking, I'm sure clever is what some people might use to describe it. Hey, why don't we address why the hell the Colonel's in our room next time?